Good morning, students. Last class we discussed about indicators effect on the acidic solution and basic solution, neutral solutions, and a few important questions. Today we discuss about electrical conductivity of acids. So what is the topic? Electrical conductivity of acids. How does acids to conduct electricity? So let me take small activity. Aim. What is our aim? To show that acid is strong or weak. To show that acid is strong or weak by using electrical conductivity. So this is the to show that acid is strong or weak by using electrical conductivity. That is our aim. Next, materials required. What are the materials required for this activity? Now, beaker, rubber cork, copper rods, connecting wires, battery, AC plug, bulb, acids. So here, what are the materials required? Beaker, rubber cork, copper rods, connecting wires, battery, AC plug, bulb, acids. Now I draw a diagram. First one. Beaker, rubber cork, set up the operators shown in the picture. Here some of the pots is there. So beaker, this one, this is the beaker, this one rubber cork, graphite rod, connecting wires, battery, bulb, AC plug, acid solution. Then procedure. So what is the procedure? So here carefully listen, point wise I can explain. First take 100 ml of beaker. Then take rubber cork, fix the bottom of the beaker. Point number 3, take graphite rods, fix on the rubber cork. So here take copper rods, fix on the rubber cork as well as set up circuit as shown in the picture. Next, pour some amount of acidic solution. Anyone, suppose take sulfuric acid solution in a beaker. Now again once I repeat this activity, first take a small, that means 100 ml of beaker, then take rubber cork, fix the bottom of the beaker, then take copper rods, fix on the rubber cork, then connect the circuit shown in the picture. Next, another one. Take some amount of sulfuric acid solution in the beaker, then switch on the plug. Then what do you notice here? What is the intensity of bulb? So when we switch on the circuit, the bulb is glowing brightly. Now here, last point, what do you notice? So when we switch on the circuit, the bulb glows brightly. What is the reason? Here sulfuric acid to produce H plus ions. These H plus ions causes to conduct electricity. So whereas repeat the activity instead of sulfuric acid, let me take acetic acid. Then what do you notice? So when we remove the sulfuric acid and then add the acetic acid, again repeat the same activity, what do you notice? So when you notice, so here the intensity of bulb is very less. At what condition we can add the acetic acid, the intensity of bulb is very low. What is the reason? Because here acetic acid to produce fewer, that means lower H plus ions. That's why bulb does not glow brightly. So finally, what is your result? Yes, the above activity I conclude that H2SO4 is strong acid, whereas acetic acid is a weak acid, because here H2SO4 to produce large number of H+ ions, whereas acetic acid to produce less plus H+ ions. That's why H2SO4 is strong acid, acetic acid is the weak acid. Next, how you can identify the strong base, weak base by using electrical conductivity. So now saying, repeat the activity. Next topic, what is that? Electrical conductivity of bases. So, how we can identify the strong base, weak base by using electrical conductivity. Now, what is our aim? Aim is to show that strong base or weak base by using electrical conductivity. So that is aim, to show that strong base or weak base by using electrical conductivity. So what are the materials required? So check it, same diagram, now observe here only one changes, basic solution we can take. So what are the materials required? Beaker, rubber cork, next copper rods, connecting wires, battery, AC plug, bulb. Finally, we can take basic solutions. Basic solutions. Now, procedure. What is the procedure? So now observe point wise, first take 100 ml of beaker, then point number 2, take rubber cork, fix bottom of the beaker. Third point, take graphite rods, fix on the rubber cork. Next, take connecting wires to connect the end of the graphite rods and another ends connect to the circuit. Next, what we have to do? Now, pour some amount of sodium hydroxide solution. Then what do you notice? Is there any changes? What is the intensity of bulb? So here, when we pour this amount of sodium hydroxide solution, then switch on the circuit, we noticed that the bulb is glowing brightly. So here, what is our observation? So when we take sodium hydroxide solution, in a beaker, then switch on the circuit, we observed the bulb is brightly glowing. So next, repeat the activity. Instead of sodium hydroxide, let we take a calcium hydroxide or barium hydroxide. Then what do you notice? So here, same points. First point, take 100 ml of beaker, take rubber cork, fix bottom of the beaker, then take graphite rods, fix on the rubber cork, take connecting wires to connect the one end graphite rods, another end circuit, then pour some amount of calcium hydroxide solution, switch on the circuit. Then what do you notice? Is there any changes? What is the intensity of bulb? So when we observe here, the intensity of bulb is very less. Intensity means what is the capacity, brightness. So here the brightness is very less. What is the reason? Here when we compare sodium hydroxide, when we take in this experiment, the bulb glowing brightly. Next, so whereas let we take calcium hydroxide, the bulb intensity is very less, because here sodium hydroxide to produce large number of OH minus ions, calcium hydroxide produce less number of OH minus ions. So finally, what is the observation? So when we observe here, sodium hydroxide is the strong base and calcium hydroxide is the weak base. That is our activity, to show that strong base, weak base by using electrical conductivity. So next, another one is there, very important topic this one. So here, why does glucose and alcohols are not considered as acids, whereas H2SO4 and CH3COOH we consider as acid? What is the reason? Could you, that means, explain with an activity? So let me take small activity. What is our topic? Why does glucose and alcohol are not considered as acids, whereas H2SO4 and CH3COOH are considered as acids? Now, what is our aim? Same this one reflect here. So glucose and alcohol are not considered as acids, whereas H2SO4 and CH3COOH are considered acids. That means aim to show that glucose and alcohol are not considered as acids, whereas H2SO4 and CH3COOH are considered as acids. Next, what are the materials required? Do you know here? Beaker. Next, second one is rubber cork, this one. Next, iron rods, you can take graphite rods also. Next, connecting wires. AC plug, bulb, battery, glucose solution, alcohol solution, dilute H2SO4, dilute acetic acid. Now procedure. So this is aim and materials required and picture. Now procedure. So here carefully listen, I will explain all the points. First, point number one. So take a 100 ml of beaker. Next, second point, take rubber cork, fix bottom of the beaker. Third point, take iron nails, fix on the rubber cork. Next, fourth point, take two different wires to connect the iron nails, another one connect the circuit. Then fifth point, pour some amount of glucose solution. Then switch on the circuit. What do you notice? Is there any changes? What is the intensity of bulb? So when we pour some amount of glucose solution in a beaker, then switch on the circuit, the bulb does not glow. Next, repeat the activity. Here, glucose solution replaced by alcohol solution. So here we did glucose solution replaced by alcohol solution. Then what do you notice? So here when we take alcohol solution in beaker, then switch on the circuit. Is there any changes? What is the intensity of bulb? So here when we notice that here the bulb does not glow, what is the reasons? Here very important point, this one. Alcohol and glucose do not conduct electricity because there is no free ions. But here glucose and alcohol also containing hydrogen but does not conduct electricity because glucose and alcohol do not associate, do not produce H plus ions. That's why glucose and alcohol are not considered as acids. Next, after repeat the activity by taking acids. Now, alcohol solution replaced by dilute sulfuric acid. So here alcohol solution replaced by dilute H2SO4. So when we take some amount of sulfuric acid in a beaker, then switch on the circuit. Then what do you notice? Is there any changes? What is the intensity of bulb. So when we take some amount of sulfuric acid, then switch on the circuit, we observe the bulb glow brightly. Next, let we take dilute HCl replaced by dilute acetic acid. Here, which one we are taking? H2SO4 replaced by acetic acid. So, take some amount of acetic acid in a beaker, then switch on the circuit. What do you notice? Is there any changes? What is the intensity of bulb? So, when we take acetic acid, then switch on the circuit, we observe the intensity of bulb is very low. What is the intensity of bulb means? The brightness is very low. So already last activity I explained how we can identify the strong acid, weak acid. So bulb is glowing brightly, we can identify the strong acid. Bulb is glowing lightly, we consider as weak acid. But here, what is our main concept? H2SO4 and acetic acid is acids or not, we can identify. Yes, here also bulb is glowing. Why? Here, H2SO4 and acetic acid to conduct electricity and we consider as acid, because H2SO4 and acetic acid to produce H+ ions. These H+ ions causes to conduct electricity. So that's why, what is the final conclusion? Our experiment, yes, the above activity, I conclude that glucose and alcohol do not produce H+ ions. That's why do not glow the bulb. We should not consider as acids. Whereas sulfuric acid and acetic acid considered as acid, because of these two acid to produce H+ ions to conduct electricity. So thank you. Remaining topic.